Coronally dispositioned pedicle graft is used when a single tooth exhibits gingival recession. And answer is sensitivity. So a coronally positioned pedicle graft is used when a single tooth exhibits gingival recession and sensitivity. Best position for apically displaced flap is, answer is at 2 mm apical to alveolar crest. So the edge of the apical displaced flap when placed 2 mm apical to the crest produces the most desirable gingival contour. The advantages of the modified Widmann flap procedure include all except. Except is postoperative interproximal architecture is normal. So the advantages of the modified Widmann flap procedure are: the procedure is feasible when implantation of bone is contemplated, and adaptation of healthy tissue to the tooth surface, and conservation of bone, and optimal coverage of root surfaces by the soft tissues. Lateral repositioning flap is done for, answer is gingival recession. Lateral repositioning flap is done for gingival recession. Isolated recession on upper teeth. Tarnow's semilunar coronally displaced flap. Absence of attached gingiva with thick pocket wall. Apically displaced flap. Absence of attached gingiva with friable pocket wall or no pocket. Free gingival graft. Long narrow gingival defect on single tooth and laterally displaced flap. So lateral repositioning flap is done for gingival recession. For isolated recession on upper teeth, Tarnow's semilunar coronally displaced flap is done, and in the absence of attached gingiva with thick pocket wall, apically displaced flap is done, and in the absence of attached gingiva with friable pocket or no pocket, free gingival graft is done. And long narrow gingival defect on a single tooth, laterally displaced flap is done. Then all of the following are definite indications of mucogingival surgery except. One wall bone defect. All other are indications, like insufficient with or attached gingiva is a mucogingival surgery. Then shallow vestibule is a mucogingival surgery. High frontal attachment, mucogingival surgery. The internal bevel incision of a periodontal flap is what? Is to remove the lining of the pocket wall. The internal bevel incision of a periodontal flap is to remove the lining of pocket wall. External bevel incision, gingivectomy, is directed towards the base of pocket and removes the pocket wall. Internal bevel incision, first incision, removes the pocket lining. Okay. The treatment option for a large area of gingival enlargement is greater than 6 teeth with osseous defects and a limited keratinized tissue. The treatment option for a large area of gingival enlargement greater than 6 teeth with osseous defects and limited keratinized tissue. The treatment option is periodontal flap. Treatment for drug-induced gingival enlargement includes, first step, oral hygiene reinforcement, possible drug substitution, recall follow-ups of at least 6 to 12 months, Second step, if enlargement persists, for small areas of enlargement, gingivectomy is employed. For large areas of enlargement, with presence of cyst defects and limited keratinized gingiva, periodontal flap surgery may be indicated. Then periodontal surgery may result in pocket elimination. Periodontal surgery may result in pocket elimination. Following periodontal surgery, the epithelial attachment healing is completed in, answer is 4 weeks. Following periodontal surgery, the epithelial attachment healing is completed in 4 weeks. Which of the following is essentially an excisional procedure of the gingiva? Answer is undisplaced flap. Undisplaced flap is essentially an excisional procedure of the gingiva. A split thickness flap is indicated when fenestrations and dehiscence are suspected. A split thickness flap is indicated when fenestrations and dehiscence are suspected. Periodontal surgery is best performed 4 weeks after completion of hygienic phase. Periodontal surgery is best performed 4 weeks after completion of the hygienic phase. Phase 1, etiotropic phase therapy, includes scaling, root planing and oral hygiene instructions. Hygiene phase, as well as caries control, occlusal therapy, replacement of defective restorations, orthodontic movement and smoking cessation. Many patients have their periodontal disease controlled with phase 1 therapy and do not require further surgical intervention. Assessment is generally made 1 to 3 months after completion of phase 1 therapy. Okay. Thick, manageable true pockets with no recession are best treated by. Thick, manageable true pockets with no recession are best treated by apically displaced flap. A lateral sliding flap done on a tooth with roots denuded for 6 years will show epithelium adjacent to previously denuded root surface. A lateral sliding flap done on a tooth with roots denuded for 6 years will show epithelium adjacent to previously denuded root surface. The reverse bevel incision is made to remove the infected tissue in sulcus. Internal bevel incision, also known as reverse bevel incision, it is the incision from which the flap is reflected to expose the underlying bone and root. It removes pocket lining, conserves the uninvolved outer surface of the gingiva, and produces a sharp, thin flap margin for adaptation to the bone-tooth junction. In modified Widmann flap, what happens? Clavicular incision is made from base of the pocket of the bone. In modified Widmann flap, clavicular incision is made from the base of the pocket of the bone. First, internal bevel incision is the first incision. Then effort is made to adapt the facial and lingual interproximal surface tissue, and see mainly indicated to provide access to the posterior areas. Then the strip technique, which is variant of free gingival graft, was developed by Han et al. The strip technique, which is a variant of the free gingival graft, was developed by Han et al. four variations to the classic free gingival graft technique has been employed. First is accordion technique, second is strip technique, third is connective tissue, and fourth is combination technique. Accordion technique involves the use of the alternate incisions on the opposite sides of the graft to attain graft expansion. Strip technique consists of obtaining two or three strips of about 1 millimeter wide and long enough to cover the entire length of the recipient site. These strips are placed at the base and at the center of the recipient site and secured by sutures. This prevents large donor site and facilitates healing in the donor site, but greater shrinkage is expected in the graft. Connective tissue techniques involves the use of connective tissue only as the graft material, as it carries the genetic information for the overlying epithelium to become keratinized. Combination technique uses the connective tissue graft at the apical or deeper portion of the recipient site and the epithelial grail on the superficial portion of the recipient site. Then the phrenectomy is a plastic surgery. Phrenectomy is a mucogingival or plastic surgical procedure for the removal of high frenal attachments. Internal bevel gingivectomy is answer is undisplaced flap. Undisplaced flap is an internal bevel gingivectomy. Criterion to distinguish between Miller class 2 and class 3 recession is interdental bone. Periodontal pockets are present on the distal side to last tooth in an arch. What is the type of suture recommended? Answer is distal wedge suture. Periodontal pockets distal to last tooth in an arch, as well as pockets on alone standing teeth, are often difficult to eliminate surgically. Treatment in those areas is often complicated by the presence of bulbous fibrous tissue over the maxillary tuberosity, prominent retromolar pad in the mandible, inadequately attached gingiva, abruptly ascending tuberosity, and a close ascending ramus of the mandible. The gingivectomy is the first approach in treating distal pockets that have no osseous lesions and adequate amount of attached gingiva. However, when only limited amounts or no keratinized tissue is present, or an angular osseous deformity is present, distal wedge procedure is advocated. Objectives of distal wedge procedure: to maintain and preserve attached gingiva, to eliminate periodontal pocket, to lengthen clinical crown, and to create easily cleansable gingiva alveolar form. The method of increasing attached gingiva is, answer is apical flap. Placement of graft will be failure in which class of recession? Answer is class 4 type of recession. Miller's classification of gingival recession, class 1 is marginal tissue recession that does not extend to mucogingival junction, no soft tissue or bone loss in interdental area. Class 2, marginal recession extends to mucogingival junction, no soft tissue or bone loss in interdental area. Class 3, marginal recession extends beyond mucogingival junction, there is soft tissue and bone loss interdentally or malpositioning of the tooth. Class 4, recession extends beyond mucogingival junction with severe soft tissue and bone loss with severe tooth malposition. The prognosis for classes 1 and 2 is excellent, whereas for class 3 partial coverage can be expected. Class 4 recession has very poor prognosis. GTR is related to GTR is related to mucogingival surgery. In Tarnow's technique, the method described for denuded root surface is semilunar coronally repositioned flap. In Tarnow's technique, the method described for denuded root surface is semilunar coronally repositioned flap. Tarnow's technique, semilunar coronally displaced flap. Miller's technique, free soft tissue autograft. Langer's technique, subepithelial connective tissue graft. Touch and tunnel technique, variant of Langer's technique. All these techniques are used to cover the surface of denuded roots. Which of the following is a mucogingival surgery? Answer is free gingival graft. The following are the mucogingival surgical techniques. Techniques of increasing the width of a tight gingiva. Example, free gingival grafts, apical displaced flap. Techniques for coverage of denuded roots. Example, laterally displaced pedicle graft, coronally displaced flap, and free gingival graft, etc. Then techniques to deepen the vestibule. Example, free autogenous graft, and techniques for the removal of frenum. The success of a free gingival graft procedure depends upon which of the following. The graft being immobilized at the recipient site. The success of a free gingival graft procedure depends upon the graft being immobilized at the recipient site. The free gingival graft should be immobilized at the recipient site because movement will interfere with healing. Excessive tension will wrap the graft. Thick blood clot interferes with graft vascularity. Respect for tissues is essential for success. In a free gingival graft, what happens to epithelium of the graft? It degenerates. The free gingival autograft is used to increase the width of attached gingiva or to cover the denuded roots. The graft consists of epithelium and a thin layer of connective tissue taken from keratinized donor sites. The ideal thickness of graft is 1 to 1.5 mm. The epithelium of the graft degenerates and is replaced newly from the borders of the recipient site. The procedure preferred for periodontal surgery in mandibular anterior region is periodontal flap. If periodontal surgery is necessary in case of horizontal bone loss in upper anterior region, which of the following procedure is most appropriate? Answer is papilla preservation flap. If periodontal surgery is necessary in case of horizontal bone loss in upper anterior region, papilla preservation flap is the most appropriate flap. The flap technique for pocket elimination and to increase the width of attached gingiva is, answer is, apically repositioned flap. Condition: for accessibility in anterior teeth segment and for reconstructive osseous surgery, the flap is papillary preservation flap. For accessibility in non-aesthetic zone, answer is modified Widmann flap. For osseous defects, closure by bone recontouring and decreased width of attached gingiva with thick pocket wall, answer is apically displaced flap. Long narrow gingival defect on a single tooth, answer is laterally displaced flap. Infrabony pockets are treated by, answer is flap operation. It is the most difficult to perform apically positioned flap procedure in, answer is facial surface of third molars. It is the most difficult to perform apically positioned flap position in the facial surface of the third molars. Which of the following has greatest impact on success of a periodontal flap surgery? Answer is level of postoperative plaque control. Which of the following has greatest impact on success of a periodontal flap surgery? Answer is level of a postoperative plaque control. The common goal of all periodontal flap surgery is, all periodontal flap procedures is to, the common goal of all periodontal flap procedures is to provided access for instrumentation. Flap technique provide adequate visibility and accessibility to the root deposits, eliminates or reduces pocket depth, expose the area to perform regenerative procedures. In periodontal flap, most important factor to be considered is is amount of attached gingiva. Adequate width of attached gingiva is a must for optimal gingival health, as it resists inflammation more efficiently and is more protective against the accumulation of the plaque. Which is true about mucogingival flap designs? Flap should be wider at the base, and it should provide an adequate exposure of the surgical area. Flap must have a broad base and good vascular supply. When placed back after surgery, flap should rest on healthy bone. Periodontal flap surgery is most difficult in second molars distally. Treatment of periodontal pockets on the distal surface of terminal molars is complicated by the lack of sufficient attached gingiva and the presence of bulbous fibrous tissue over tuberosity and retromolar pad. An apically prepositioned flap does not preserve the attached gingiva. Does not increase the length of clinical crown. Answer is, it is a pocket elimination procedure. Apically displaced flap can be used for pocket elimination or widening the zone of attached gingiva. The pocket wall is transformed into attached gingiva. It increases the length of clinical crown and is not indicated for palatal pockets. The width of the attached gingiva is increased approximately half the pre-treatment pocket depth.